Greetings, fellow detectives. Wizard Kitten here, bringing you a new build in my series, Building Nancy Drew in The Sims 4. Today, I am bringing you part 2 of the Technology of Tomorrow Today lab from Nancy Drew, the Deadly Device. Last week, I brought you part 1 of the lab build, which kind of involved putting together the floor plan and completing the entire basement level. So that includes Gray's office, Nico's old office, the staff lounge, the main area on the bottom, as well as the entire lab. So if you want to check out that video, I'll be sure to put a card in the upper corner if you haven't seen that yet. But today's video is focusing on the entire second level of the lab itself. The offices for Ellie York and Mason Quinto, who are two of the scientists that work at the lab. And then I also work on the garage for where the character Ryan works, where she is kind of working as the mechanical engineer for the team. And then I do the entire exterior of the build as well. Before I get too far into the build, I just did want to do a quick plug for my second channel. If you haven't heard yet, I have started a second channel as a podcast style YouTube channel, really focused on perfectionism. It's called Perfectionist Synonymous, and it will be linked in the description box of this video, as well as any of my most recent videos. But that podcast is really focusing on just the kinds of perfectionistic messaging that we get from society and how that really impacts us. And it's not just for perfectionists. I think it really, it's supposed to be for people who maybe have people-pleasing tendencies, or people who have high levels of anxiety or stress, people who feel like their self-worth feels really low, or their self-esteem feels really low, especially because of the kinds of pressures that society puts on us. So if you that sounds interesting to you and you haven't checked it out yet, that will be linked in the description box down below. Just wanted to plug that a little bit. But anyway, we are working on the office spaces now for Ellie and Mason. This might, I don't know, on the second level, this is definitely my favorite room. I don't think it's my favorite room overall. I do really like how the staff lounge turned out on the first level, but I do also really enjoy how this room came together. It is also the only room in the entire building that has windows, which I think is kind of funny. Part of that is because it's the only room in the screenshots on the second level that has windows. There are a couple rooms on the basement level that also appear to have windows in the game, namely the teacher's lounge, but I decided to make the bottom level just a full-on basement for a couple of reasons. One, it's really difficult to do any sort of kind of like split leveling stuff, even with the platform tool. It just doesn't really work as well, or to do kind of like slopes where this build would be on a hill or something like that. And two, it does make gameplay go very, very smooth when your sim is in a basement level, because then the game doesn't have to render all of the environmental graphics as well. It doesn't have to get all of the trees or all of the buildings in the distance, any of that, which means that if you were using this as the scientist lab, then your gameplay would be very smooth anytime that you're on that basement level. It was also very smooth for me when I was on this top level, and honestly, that's probably because most of the items in this build are actually decorative. A lot of the items are from the Get to Work expansion pack, and a lot of the industrial type items from that pack are just kind of scattered throughout this build to fill in all of the empty space. But of course, we have all of the practical areas as well that we would see in the game. Right now I'm working on Ellie's cubicle, and I actually really enjoy how it turned out. I think it looks very much like Ellie's space. I tried to keep it as cluttered. I tried to use the same clutter items that we see in the game on her desk space, on her workspace. I use these island counters because it does seem like their workspace is just kind of an elevated desk. It's not just a standard desk, and I thought this got the look across better. But yeah, really love how this came together, all of the clutter, everything kind of just scattered everywhere, especially when we look at it in contrast to Mason's space, because we know that Mason is definitely a little bit more concerned with having all of his things exactly in the right place, everything lined up nicely, everything nice and clean. So I wanted to make sure that there was really a very strong contrast between the two spaces, where you could tell one is definitely Ellie's, One is definitely Mason's, and of course, based off of the items in the games that, in the game Deadly Device, that each of them has in their workspaces as well. To make the floor plan work, I did also add this little file room on the side. I was trying to make the cubicles look roughly the same shape as they were in the game. And in order to do that, I ended up with kind of this little square at the back, which I just turned into a file and storage room, which seems very practical to me. It seems like something that definitely would be in the lab itself that would be important to have. So, nice little addition there. Every time I pause, I am looking at my own walkthrough of the Deadly Device. All of the walkthroughs are on the channel as well, and the Deadly Device is one of my favorite games, probably one of my favorite walkthroughs, just because it's such a fun and challenging game to play. I really enjoy it as a modern mystery. I mentioned this in the first video for this build that I did too, but it does such a nice job of bringing in so many of the good modern elements of the Nancy Drew series, as well as harkening back to the classical era of the games. I just really appreciate it for that. It's a great game. So we are adding in all of these crates now for Mason because he actually has these in his space, which I think is kind of funny because when I look at those crates, they don't necessarily seem organized to me. Maybe that's just like in my brain, that doesn't seem like a very good organizational system because it would not work for me. I would get those crates so messy and I would be so tempted to just put all sorts of random things in those crates rather than actually keep them organized. But perhaps for Mason, it's a really good system to just keep things off his desk. Like maybe he has a whole crate for like paperwork that he's currently working on, or a whole crate for like writing utensils, a whole crate for calculators, whatever he needs, that kind of thing. Mason also has a couple of cars, so I made sure to put cars up on these little shelves for him. Again, just trying to add in the details that the characters do actually have in the game. The radio, Mason does not have, but he has a printer. So the radio is standing in for the printer. We do not have printers in The Sims 4. The Sims computers do not have printers, nor have they ever needed them. Who knows, maybe they will one day. So now we're working on just a couple of extra details in this main hallway before we move on to the main garage space. And the layout of the garage is different than it is in the game itself. I had to make a few modifications to it in order to make it work. But overall, I'm actually really proud of myself for making the floor plan of this build perfectly, or like nearly perfectly, match the floor plan of the Technology of Tomorrow Today lab within the game. So the only difference is that sometimes doors are in different places, but all of the rooms are in the same place. The staircases all are in the same places. The scale of the rooms and the way that a Sim moves around them compared to how Nancy moves around them actually makes a lot of sense. And I avoided doing this build for a very long time precisely because I was afraid of that. I was afraid, especially since we never really get a very clear view of the outside of this lab. We get a little screenshot at the very beginning where you can kind of see what it's supposed to look like, but you don't really get a very clear view of the floor plan or what the outside of the building is supposed to look like. So I ended up being very happy with how everything came together, where all of the rooms are placed. The red bicycles are symbolizing Ryan's beloved motorcycle. We don't have motorcycles in The Sims 4. Who knows if we ever will, but the bicycles, I thought, got the same idea across. And honestly, for the science career, having the bicycles available would actually be really helpful, because every once in a while, your scientist Sims get little prompts that they need to go and harvest crystals or something like that, and your Sim needs to travel quite a distance in order to do that, or sometimes they need to go fishing at the lake that's near the lab too. I did place this lab in the space where the scientist career does take place, and it was functional. I did have a Sim who was working as a scientist, and she was able to perform all of her duties at this space. After I took the screenshots, I did a little bit of player testing to make sure that the Sims could move around the area. They were using the staff lounge and getting themselves snacks. The bathroom works great. They were using all of the scientist equipment. She was able to complete all of the tasks that were on her list, so I was just like very excited about that. that. I was very happy that things appeared to be working, and I am now very inspired to just in my free time play The Sims 4 with the scientist career again. It's been a while since I've done that, but to play it in this lab and pretend like I work in Nancy's universe at the Technology of Tomorrow Today lab, oh, absolutely love that idea. Very excited for that. Also very excited to be using these vents again. The Sims 4 Industrial Loft Kit honestly was probably worth it for those vents alone, because just being able to have some sort of architectural ceiling detail to give more depth to the space made such a difference. It was really, really nice to have those on the first level of this build, and I was very happy to be able to add them into the garage as well. It just makes it feel so much more like an industrial space, so much more like a lab. Very happy to have those. So now we are working on the exterior of the build. I used the initial screenshot, like I mentioned, of the game to kind of give me an idea of like the coloring that I was supposed to be going for, the shape I was supposed to be going for. It did look like the majority of the roof was flat, like there weren't necessarily any actual kind of sloping roof pieces. However, just to give the build a little bit more depth, I wanted to use some sloping roof pieces here and there. And then I also just used a bunch of roof decorations to kind of fill in the space. Again, we want this space to look extremely industrial. We want it to buzz and hum and have a bunch of moving pieces. We want everything to look very mechanical, and it definitely achieves that. That's one of the other fun things when I was player testing this is my sim, when she was working in the lab, there was just like so many noises and lab sounds, like things were buzzing. You could hear like welding noises. So you could imagine that like Ryan was there. It was just so much fun. On the exterior of the build as well, I did include the observatory and a couple of the rocket science stations, because your Sims do sometimes get those kinds of tasks for the scientist career, so I thought it was important to include those. Plus, it also just gave me the opportunity to kind of have some fenced-in areas for the lab itself, which was just kind of nice to add some more dimension to give it a little bit more of an idea of space. And I was very happy to find this brick color, because it ended up being like the perfect brick color. I was so happy with it. Just so happy with this build in general. Again, this is one that I was really intimidated by, and am just happy that I was able to kind of pull it off with any semblance of success. So you guys will have to let me know down in the comments what you think of this build. The only builds that I have left are builds that intimidate me, so it's taking me a little bit of courage to kind of get started with them, get going with them. But I'm finding that once I get started, it's really not as bad as I think it's gonna be. Everything is doable, especially if you allow yourself to kind of put your own spin on things when you can't find a perfect match or do a perfect floor plan or scale. So it's been fun. Curse of Blackmoor Manor. I do have to do Blackmoor Manor. I have to do Castle Finster. Those two are both going to be massive undertakings. Castle Finster I'm even more concerned about than Blackmoor Manor, honestly, because we have absolutely no idea what the floor plan of Castle Finster is like. And I'm also wondering, am I supposed to do the courtyard? Like the whole, all of the houses that surround it? I mean, the courtyard is beautiful, but then I would be furnishing like six houses in addition to building the castle itself. And there's so many just like empty rooms in the castle. There's so many places that are just like, I don't know, we don't see, but there's all this empty space. Castle Finster scares me. That's gonna be a tough one. Castle Finster, Blackmoor Manor, Beech Hill. Beech Hill intimidates me because of the pyramid in the middle. Everything else I think is very doable. I can make a museum in The Sims. I've done it before. I did a Labyrinth of Lies build. I did the Phidias Cultural Center. That's up on the gallery as well, as is this build, by the way. So that I'm not worried about, but I am very worried about trying to figure out how to do something that evokes the idea of that pyramid, because it's so central to the mystery and it's honestly like the coolest part of the mystery, that I don't want to eliminate it completely, even though you can't really have like a building inside a building. So Gotta figure something out for that, so that's gonna take some problem solving as well. That's why I haven't started that one. For each of these big builds, I have a reason I haven't done them yet. There's something specific about them that intimidates me and has been keeping them from me. But as we see with this one, it is possible. I have learned, and I will get to those other builds soon. But we are coming up on the screenshots here very soon, fellow detectives. Please let me know what you think of the build, and if you like it. And please let me know what other builds you're excited to see in the future. Thank you so much for watching. Please feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more Nancy Drew and Sims 4 content. Thank you so much for watching, fellow detectives. I will see you soon.